The 12th edition of the Rotary Cancer Run today drew thousands to Lobogo Millennium Grounds eager to contribute to a noble cause. This year's proceeds are aimed at completing the one-stop cancer center at Insambia Hospital. The event kicked off with vibrant aerobic sessions, setting the energy high. By 6:30 a.m., District Governor 9213 Anne Nkotu flagged off the first wave of runners taking on the 21-kilometer challenge. Minutes later, the 10-kilometer runners were given the green light by District Governor 9214 Agnes Batenga. The final wave, a 5-kilometer run, began shortly after. Michael Nietegeka, the head organizer of the Rotary Cancer Run, expressed his deep gratitude to the participants.
As we speak now, the figure has hit 2.5 billion shillings net. Available on the account.
As the sun set on this year's Rotary Cancer Run, the message was clear. The fight against cancer is far from over, but with collective effort and determination, a cancer-free future is within reach.
Vision Group, thank you so much.
The Right Honourable Speaker Anita Among met with His Holiness Pope Francis in a private audience at the Vatican yesterday, August 24th. After this meeting, she also held discussions with His Eminence Pietro Parolin, the Vatican Secretary of State, to explore ways to strengthen bilateral relations between Uganda and the Vatican. This marks her third private audience with the Pontiff in less than 2 years. The Speaker is overheard telling the Pope, "You are welcome again. Uganda loves you so much." The visit comes amid ongoing scrutiny and sanctions against Among, who has faced allegations of corruption and human rights abuses. Sudan's de facto ruler, Army Chief Abdel Fattah al-Burhan, said Saturday his government would not join peace talks with rival paramilitaries in Switzerland, vowing instead to fight for 100 years. The United States opened talks in Switzerland on August 14th aimed at easing human suffering and achieving a lasting ceasefire. While an RSF delegation showed up, the Sudanese armed forces were unhappy with the format and did not attend, though they were in telephone contact with the mediators. The talks were co-hosted by Saudi Arabia in Switzerland, with the African Union, Egypt, the United Arab Emirates and the United Nations, completing the so-called Alliance for Advancing Life-Saving and Peace in Sudan group. They wrapped up on Friday without a ceasefire, but with progress on securing aid access on two key routes into the country, which is gripped by one of the world's worst humanitarian crises. هذه مليشة ما لم تنتهي ما لم نحرر كل شيء هم لنسوه هذه حرب ما تنتهي.